Philae in Latin, we would say Philae. It's going to hook up, going to connect, going to touch the comet. It's really an extraordinary thing. And it's done by the European Space Agency. The mission has lasted 10 years, I think. Because the distances in space are just enormous. There's a lot of space in space. And for those of you who have not done this, please visit planetary.org and look at the photographs, the pictures coming back from this thing. You can see what people have speculated a lot about the nature of cometary bodies, comets and asteroids, is they're not a single rock. It's a gravel. It's a rubble pile, as we like to say. These rocks are held together by their tiny but nevertheless non-zero amount of gravity. Just rendezvousing with this comet is an extraordinary thing. It's compared to the vastness of space, it's a very, very small object. Yet it is part of the primordial solar system. There's going to be something there that no one's ever thought of. We're going to make discoveries that no one's imagined yet. And we're going to have this adventure. This is the thing about exploration. When you explore, you're going to have two things. You're going to make discoveries. There'll be stuff out there that no one's thought of. Something about ice, something about rock, something about gravity, something about orbital motion, something about iridium, I'm making that up. Something about elements that we don't think about too much. And you're going to have an adventure. There's going to be an adventure. Landing the spacecraft, watching the object come closer and closer, that's going to be exciting. And as we say all the time, what are you guys going to find out there? We don't know what we're going to find. That's why we're looking. And it is, as I like to always do, I tie it back to the only preventable natural disaster, which is the Earth getting hit with an asteroid. For me, practically, you can see that if you were to set off an explosive here to try to deflect this thing, if it were going to hit the Earth, this one's not going to hit the Earth, everybody. But if there were another one that were going to hit the Earth, you can see that if you just tried to push it, you probably wouldn't influence it properly. You'd just make it scatter and you might make things worse. So that's why we at the Planetary Society advocate our laser bees program, where we zap the surface of one of these with lasers. But that aside, I hope to be among the people that does not go the way of the ancient dinosaurs. There is no evidence at all that the ancient dinosaurs had a space program. And it cost them.